Filipino pride and gay pride walked hand in hand along one of America's most iconic streets as Los Angeles held its annual gay pride parade and block party in Hollywood this past weekend.
It is very fun, and at the same time with the intention of reminding ourselves that this began as a protest and it will continue to be. Freedom for everybody, trans power, everyone.
For you, because
Kathleen Rawson of the nonprofit that manages the Hollywood Entertainment District says the event seeks, among others, to give people a break from many of the negative things happening recently.
This is a reprieve from that. This isn't a moment to just come out, enjoy your neighborhood, enjoy the people who are living here, dance, hug. You know, that it's exactly what we need. The entire country is facing a real epidemic of loneliness. Come out. If you're lonely, this is the spot for you, because it's bursting, literally bursting with pride.
Accepting. I'm happy that I have a place where I can be myself, I can be safe, I can just be here with my friends gallivanting around.
And for the third year, the group Filipino-American Los Angeles Democrats joined the mile-long procession to represent FilAms.
It's been a lot of fun, but I think more importantly, college recognizes the significance of pride and diversity in our community.
Among those leading the way down Hollywood Boulevard was Culver City School District's board member Stephanie Laredo, who also identifies as queer.
It's so important for us to advocate on behalf of our students to affirm their identities, make sure that they are able to dream big and to realize that it gets better and to persevere so that they can achieve success in their education.
And while Filipinos are proud to represent their roots on the Pride route, they're also hoping to represent a little bit more when it comes to Election Day.
Los Angeles City Council candidate Isabel Jurado took the pilot's float, representing not just the Filipino community, but also the LGBTQIA+ community. The community leader vows to represent both communities before the City Council if elected this November.
It's so special to be part of my Filipino community with Palad and be out here being, you know, loud and queer. We have so much family out here, and we're just going to bring the joy. If elected, I would be the only one that's openly queer on council, so I'd be the only representative, and I would just be so heartened to bring that representation back to City Hall.
Also in this massive group of LGBTQIA+ community members and allies, FilAm State Attorney General Rob Bonta and his Deputy Chief of Staff Jessica Coloza, who is running for the California State Assembly's 52nd District also in November. As they march with Equity California and Grand Marshal George Takei, they will continue to fight for the rights and freedoms of the gay community, ensuring they can live pridefully happy lives. Steve Angel, ABS-CBN News, Hollywood.